Hello, and welcome to the second episode of the second campaign of the Chronicles of Telmora. For our players tonight, I will be introducing them in order, and then I will introduce myself. Connor's not here yet. He'll be here in about 10 minutes-ish, so we decided to start without him because he's at the other temple anyway, and he's the one who's late. So, for the people that are actually here, we have Harka, played by Norvin.
I'm a little dry.
He is a little dry, ladies and gents. We have Sister Liliboria, played by Shane.
Hello.
We have Tess Keenjaw, played by Pyro.
I'm eating all the rats.
Good for you, buddy. And we have Icarus, played by Nasir.
Howdy.
Hidely hodly, good neighbor. All right, when last we left our new friends, new party of adventurers, they had, for some of them, made their way to the village of Cressa, or for some of them are from that area anyway, in response to a call from the mayor to identify and either eliminate or assuage the fears of the locals about some mysterious figures seen in the forest that had made some of the local trade routes nervous and unwilling to pass through into the village. You all ventured out into the forest, destroyed the ashen creatures, and made your way following a figure made out of flame to Sister Liliboria's temple, where the figure was assumed to be the avatar of Sarenrae, and spoke to you all, asking you to venture to the other temples around Ascaria, or not Ascaria, fuck, that's our last continent, Kalagios, that's where we are this time. A mysterious force that is seeking to usurp the power of the creators for an unknown purpose, and it seems to be seeking out their temples and desecrating them to lessen their influence on Telmora. So, with your new quest to journey to the temples across the continent and repair the damage that has done to prevent wide-scale disaster, you took a rest at Sister Liliboria's temple, except for Rex, who went back to his own little temple house. And we will be getting to him when he gets here.
Soon. Victory's mine, I send it to you.
What? Aha!
Save the map.
Oh, that's such a pretty name of it, too. Can I tell everybody the name of it?
Sure.
It's the Temple of the Restful Lily.
Duh.
I didn't name it, but...
Oh.
Duh.
I thought you made Sorry. That map.
No. I highly edited a map that was already made. But the name stayed.
I mean, listen, Temple of the Restful Lily is a really appropriate name for this, not gonna lie. Go ahead and upload that real quick, and then I will...
That's why when I downloaded it, it popped up. I was like, you know what? It's fine.
I'm gonna upload that and then drag y'all onto that page.
Yeah!
As I am doing that, if you would like to all describe as you wake up. I believe I should have appropriately put you on the temple map now.
This is nice.
Isn't it pretty?
Wake
up. I mean your walls.
Oh. There we go. Now I can see you more clearly. I still had myself on the map layer, and so you looked weird.
Hmm.
Make the grid slightly more opaque. So, it is the morning. You are all awake. What are you doing?
I'll kick myself in. Could I have, first, I assume we're going to press play on the music.
Yes, thank you.
And second...
It seems that it is very small.
Would you like me to make it larger?
It would probably help.
Okay.
I would like to do
while I'm fucking around with this.
Isn't there a grid on it? I can count the squares if you want. I still have the window open.
Right now it's at 20 by 29 on the roll 20 page.
It looks like 35 columns, 50 rows.
Okay, so 35
height, 50.
No, it'd be 35 width if it's columns.
Yes, yes. I'm autistic. Don't worry about it.
Okay, 35 by 50. Save.
Damn, that tall as shit. I think it'll be okay.
Think it'll be okay.
Yeah, I think it'll be okay.
I think we'll survive. Where's the side? There it is. Drag, drag, drag. Y'all can do what you're
I'm being doing and talk about.
I think we're all witnessing.
Whoa! Whoa! There we go.
Anyway.
All right. Put myself back on the objects and tokens layer. That is a much better size.
I'm up to
yes,
on the couch.
Yes. Good.
Dungeon Master, I would like to have gotten up 2 hours before everyone else.
Yeah, that's
and
fine.
Hunted down an amount of vermin. And then take their bones and random bits of shiny trash and make him make friendship necklaces for everyone.
Roll me a d10.
Yes, I will do this.
Oh, yeah. I like to imagine Tess just
find
snuck out the window.
You find six rats. I'm just going to say they're rats.
Alright, so, and lots of shiny shiny shit, I managed to bore a little hole in for a little string. And I make little trash necklaces for her.
Did Harka just slip outside?
It would appear that way, yes.
And now Tess is going to give her a walk around giving everyone little trash necklaces. So, let's see who I approach first.
You're coming in through the front door, you would run into Icarus and the Lord. You're coming in back through the window you snuck out of. Nice. I don't know. Depends on where you go.
I'm going to roll for who I approach first. Yes, yes. So let's see. There's three here. So I'm going to roll D3. I think you know which one you are, Shane.
yeah.
Arca is 3 and Bird Buddy is 1.
4 again, another 4.
Two's yeah. Attack.
So, Sister Liboria,
you will walk in and see Liboria handing tea to Icarus.
Thank you.
You see Tess walk up to you with a little bundle in her hand.
What's that?
Well, you guys are the first. Not nice people I've met since I got here. So, I made you something.
And I will take out a little necklace with little... Let's see here. On this one, there's going to be little bones. There's a shiny river rock that looks like the one I gave the bard. What appears to be a little piece of burnt firewood. All wrapped up in a little, let's see, lady. Yeah, this one will be a bracelet.
Cute.
Meh.
It's a bracelet?
Yeah.
Is this for me?
Yeah.
She'll slip it on, smile. Thank you, Tess.
Gives you a beaming smile, turns like immediately to Icarus.
You too.
Why? Thanks.
This one, much the same with the rat bones. However, there are nondescript feathers from possibly nearby avian things. There's definitely less pigeons around.
Used to be nearby avian things. Now they're lunch.
Yes. Kind of kneaded together along the twine, as well as, let's see here, what was it?
Real quick, Harka, since you would have slipped past this room to get back there, Would you have done anything, said anything to Icarus or Boreal while you did that? You just walked past?
Would have walked past half asleep, mumbling something about coffee.
And I was about to say, talk to me until I've had my coffee.
Okay. Well, before Tess runs off, Noleboria will reach out. Harka's in the back. Could you bring this to him? And it'll be a cup of coffee.
What's that?
It's just a drink for him.
Oh, can I have some?
I have some extra back here.
Oh, no.
Oh, does it taste good?
That's happily subjective. No. But you can try some when you come back, okay?
Okay. Oh, and then this last piece here, this is the a fang from a dog that tried to bite me like 2 days ago. Here you go.
And hands the this one is a necklace off to Icarus. Notices you have the bird hands.
Why? Thank you, Tess.
Yeah.
And then I will wander out towards Harka, holding a steaming cup of coffee.
Sister will turn towards Icarus.
Calisthenics.
Sister will turn towards Icarus. I hope she doesn't trip on a rug.
That would probably be for the best if she doesn't.
He watches you stretch for a moment.
Hey there, Munchkin. What do you need?
Lily said to bring you coffee.
Well, he'll reach out, grab it. You didn't drink any of this, did you?
No.
Okay, good. Coffee's for big people. It'll make small people like you, their hearts will explode. So never drink it.
Oh no! Why did you say that right after Sister said she could chug some?
Tess will look at you and puff out her cheeks.
I'm a little dragon!
Would you like a deception check?
No, I'm going to count on you with blind pride of a small dragon.
I'm a dragon. I can do anything.
Puffs out of cheeks. Right.
Then may I suggest? Yeah, never mind. Thank you.
Oh, I made you this too.
And this one looks at your horns. Well, will be also a necklace. This one has less rat bones, more several what appears to be teeth, and one is a shard of a prism. Little bits of dry fleck blood on it. It is probably one of my discarded arrowheads.
This is lovely. I'm not one for necklaces. So he'll do that little loop thing that you can do with necklaces around his belt. And it'll hang from his hip. Thank you, Munchkin.
She'll look extremely pleased with this, so I'll skitter back inside.
I'm a little dragon. I could take coffee, whatever that is. Me.
And just skitter. Right up to Sister Gloria.
Looks he wants to watch the heart palpitations.
He just climbs up on the stool and looks at the Sister Lulabori expectantly.
Okay, Tess. Just please understand that this is very bitter.
Wow.
And she'll slide a small little cup of coffee in front of her.
Is that decaf?
No. It's the same that you had.
How strong was the coffee?
Yeah, it was made.
It was over average.
You're watching her today.
Well,
she'll just sigh.
Tess looks at you. I mean, bitter? Can you make it sweeter?
She'll fumble around behind the counter. I suppose I can put some sugar in it.
No, use milk.
Oh, yes. She'll just tap the side of her head. That'll be back here.
I thought something else was about to happen now, so we're gonna have heart palpitations out of game.
And she'll stroll back here to grab some.
Cream, if you have that.
Gonna get some, breast milk. No, I mean breast milk.
Yes, but robot, so none of hell.
Robot.
I'm willing to try.
Hold on now.
Joke.
Anyway, she will pour some in.
And since no one said not to, it's going to pick up this thimble sized drink and knock it back like a shot glass.
Oh.
So,
when in Rome, Harker will do the same.
For those of us that have drank straight black coffee.
Yeah.
It's not pleasant.
Unless you are really into bitter things, it is not a fun time. Especially when you're downing it like a shot. And I have to imagine that it's still hot. So, Tess, the first thing that hits you is warm. And you really like that. And then your face scrunches up at the worst flavor you have ever experienced.
There's now an after image of where Tess was.
I'm trying to think of how exactly I want to deal with the caffeine. Do I want to have... Yes, I have had exactly... Make me a constitution saving throw.
Beata Maria.
It's a low DC.
What's a good roll to avoid laughing his ass off?
That was the DC you needed 10. To make, was a 10. So you don't immediately like latch onto the ceiling. Hark, I'll let you decide if that's enough for you to avoid laughing your ass off. You hear this weird like clicking noise. This weird like clicking tapping noise. And you look down, and it's your little tiny kobold claws clacking against the hard surface. This is an actual thing that has happened to me in real life the first and only time I drank a 5-hour energy. I heard like thump, 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 and I was like, what the fuck? And I looked down, and it was my hand vibrating against the table.
So yeah, I've knocked back and fell onto the floor. I'm no longer on the floor.
Where are
you? I'm tapping on the floor.
You're tapping on the floor.
I'm tapping on the floor. And now I'm in a chair. And now I'm out the window.
Oh.
And now I'm in the trees.
That's not a window, that's a fireplace.
Now I'm on the roof.
Warm. Make me a dexterity acrobatics check.
Told you shouldn't have given that to her.
Sister will just shake her head as she looks downtrodden and just run out the door.
It takes you a couple tries. You kind of scoot down the foliage a little bit, but it's kind of vined and ivied on the outside, so it takes you a couple tries to get all the way up onto the roof, and Sister Liliboria comes out like just as you're about to climb over onto the very top of the roof. Actually,
Tess, please.
Real quick, just because you're on the roof, I'm going to remind you of the architecture of the roof. If you would like to just ping where on the roof you are trying to get up.
Well, based on the map, she'd be over here.
Over here?
That's where she would have just climbed up.
Yep, so you are, I'll say you're like perched on top of this spire like a little gargoyle.
You'd say the line, you're Batman.
Hey, Batman!
Tess, please come down before you hurt yourself.
Like, looks down at you, the full cat eye slits just as they slowly dilate as
are
I see another bird
in silly mode.
I in fact see a bird here, and I'm doing that little cat about to jump, wiggling their asses about to fling themselves.
Oh shit!
Yeah,
Parker will try to get underneath you, so if you do come to the floor, he'll catch you.
All right, I go for the bird. I missed.
Make me an acrobatics check. Well.
The athletics to jump.
Yeah, athletics, because you're trying to jump and use your strength
yes.
to prepare your prepare
even
yourself
better.
To target.
This is how it happens.
Yeah! Oh no!
So you know those videos of where the cat jumps yep. and then just like holds the position in air and falls.
All right, so what am I rolling to try to catch this kobold?
I'm gonna say this. This is you're prepared for this, so. I will
this
let you
is what we
train
for.
Acrobatics or athletics. That 16 is enough. The DC was a bit higher with the natural zero.
Yeah.
A natural
let's all give Pyro a round of applause for our first zero of the campaign.
First zero of the campaign. Woo. Zeros in the chat.
Certified cat woohoo.
You do. It's. It is
let's say it knocks the wind out of me so we can have the baby.
Yeah. You kind of like splat into Harka's waiting arms.
You forgot he's wearing armor already. Okay. Just fall onto the windshield.
Hi. I
have beans, cheese, and meat.
Ooh, beans, cheese, and meat.
Oh, sorry about fuck. I unmuted at the wrong fucking time.
Oh, beef.
That's the right.
So, yeah,
time.
I mean, Harka isn't. I mean, he's got a strength of 20, so catching you's no issue.
Yeah.
You just bounce into him.
Yeah, I think more the issue is I've landed right on your chest plate. All right.
Well,
yeah, I will say
that's slightly harder than the floor, but not quite as far down.
Oh no! You take 6 points of bludgeoning damage.
Oh, he'll back five.
Good night. Thank you.
And I probably go back to sleep.
No, you're
damage.
Still really amped up. You're still pretty
so,
amped
sir,
up. You're just now using
on.
That amped up to be cautious.
They're on the ground now, right?
Yeah.
Sister will just lean down, hand on the back of Tess, and cast Lesser Restoration.
Damn.
Oh, there you go.
Thank
yes,
you.
That will work. I was going to be
the
like,
bit has ended.
About
Thank
an
you.
Hour from now, I was going to have you make a higher DC constitution saving throw for the crash. But Lesser Restoration effectively ends that.
Right,
your eyes undilate to normal size.
I gently reach up and clasp my hands around the laborious hand.
That tasted awful.
I'm gonna pass out.
All right. Well, Harko will reach down, pick her up like a suitcase. I guess yeah. I got a suitcase for the day.
I have a crocodile skin suitcase.
We can cast haste on her anytime we want to now.
Please, no.
Pyro's Erda Yuhu drink. I'll be right back.
I'm gonna put you back in the regular temple.
Yeah, welcome to one of our sessions. lay Tess on this couch. That's where I would put her.
Yeah, that's where I was going.
And Harka's going to go back and plop down in his recliner.
Pop the footstool out.
Yeah. So, what are we doing today?
Well, once Rex gets back, I assume we'll decide on how we want to start traveling, if you're still willing.
Yeah. I just have the simple suggestion of not going to Izith Asari first.
Oh?
Yeah.
Why is that? If you don't mind.
I don't want to go there.
Okay. That's fair.
Yeah. Let's just stick with that.
Right. Well,
Hey, Liv, I believe
I have a map somewhere. Yes?
Liv.
Oh, yes.
Will you put us on the world map? I'm putting in notes for so I can just read them for myself.
Absolutely.
On where I left someone.
Yep. Yes, you remember where you left her. I have that written in your thing.
All right. So where are we right now?
Cressa. Which Cressa. Is that? Yeah.
So.
Yes.
I assume we didn't. Did we fix the issue here in Cressa, or is it
yes.
still okay? So we're either going to. We can either go to. I cannot read that.
Azmarin,
the Frozen Tower, or Iseth first. And Harka's vote is any of them but Iseth.
Well, if we do travel out to the Frozen Tower, it would make sense to go to Iseth after that. So while we're already
relatively
east
close,
of the continent,
Azmarin. Yes. Is that a port city?
Ish, yeah. It's not as big of a port as Iseth Asari. But Pyra will understand this. It's the difference between, like, Corpus
Water
Christi
Deep
and
Baldur's
Galveston.
Gate?
Corpus Christi what?
And Galveston.
Yeah.
Okay,
Waters
so...
Deep is pretty big.
Yeah, Waters
you,
Deep
like,
and Baldur's
you have,
Gate.
You
They're
have, like,
big.
It's a port city. It's just it's a smaller one compared to the main port city.
Yeah, Waterdeep is the main port city. Baldur's Gate is not.
Baldur's Gate's pretty big.
Listen,
I'm not
I've
saying
never
it's
played
small,
anything in the Sword
dude.
Coast.
Okay,
yeah,
I'm
saying
gonna,
they're about the same.
It's less about size. It's more like the access to opulence. There is a higher amount of trade flowing through there.
Yeah. All right. So my suggestion is we go to Azmarin, then we hire a boat to get us all the way to the Frozen Tower. And then we do anything else.
And then we go anywhere else in the world.
Sister will sigh. Well, I guess we can get to that when we get to it. Do-do, check mark.
Have you put your suitcase down?
It's now been 30 minutes.
Yeah, you're in a, on sleeping on the couch.
Thank you. Just lying there. Just a shaky thumbs up to him, to just whatever. So since Hargrove's the first one who spoke, she'll like,
okay, I like that.
Okay, so real quick, do I send Connor a decent meme? Do I send him a threatening meme, or do I send him a very threatening
meme? Do I actively call him
okay.
on his phone?
Which one?
Very threatening.
Very threatening? Okay.
About to beat you to death. 32 minutes later. It has been 32 minutes, everyone, since Connor, in the Discord chat with timestamps, said, give me another 10 minutes. In a slight sense of his defense, he did say, or start without me, which could have meant... either give me 10 minutes and I will for sure be there, or if you start without me, I'm not going to worry about how long it takes. Either way, he should have communicated that. But here we are.
Also, Pyro, I want you to realize something.
Yeah.
The type of person Harka is, you literally just paid him. You have a favor friend. From the grump.
Friend.
I also, yeah, your job I is really, to be friend. Tess, I really expected when you were doing the thing with the necklaces and sister asked you what it was, I was really, for a split second, expecting you to go, trash! So proud. So proud of what you had to be like, it's trash here.
I haven't done the, I haven't fully, like, channeled my gremlin into a character before. This is great. I'm having a good time.
Gremlin?
No. Little gremlin. Wholesome little gremlin. Okay. Merlin's okay, something else.
Fair enough.
He's
fair
a
enough.
Different creature.
Fair enough. Respected.
Merlin's a threat to society.
Well, I we guess we're still waiting on not. Connor.
Tess is a threat to a small municipality.
Back to the temple map, please.
Yes, I'm very you. Appreciating the Merlin is a threat to society. Tess is a threat to a small municipality. That's really wonderful.
Just gotta love love first.
I have a lot of feelings about that. That's very clever. Okay. Well, Tess, you know where Rex's temple is, so there is no reason for you all to wait for him here for him to find you, since you can lead people to where he is.
Yes, so but that means like if venture... he's not back yet when we get there, then we stare at an NPC Rex.
No, but I was about to say, if there are things you would like to do into town...
Well, we're going to be traveling over land for a while, and we have some supplies, but not a lot.
Allow me to put you back on the Cressa art. I'm not going to call it a map. It's just art.
Now, are we going to be worrying about rations here?
I mean, it's Liv, so no.
Not a lot. Do you have an Outlander in your party?
Do we have a Ranger in our party?
You do. No, you don't. You don't have a ranger.
What?
We do you have a druid, Connor. Though.
You, do, you and do. Connor. You keep Sorry. Thinking I'm a goddamn ranger.
You do have an outlander. Connor is an outlander.
So we do not need to worry about food in the least.
A druid outlander, yeah.
Yeah, druid right. outlander. We're fine.
Yeah.
He manages to pound good berry.
Worst case scenario, Goodberry. I think I'll buy another bundle of arrows, so gold.
Okay. Yep,
especially gold. Since I don't even need food.
That's very true.
I stocked up on a rat.
Right. I want a tent.
A tent?
Yes.
Me, I believe that is...
50.
Me pull up the equipment in the player's handbook.
In case you don't know anything.
In case I don't know anything, which I don't. Okay, so a two-person tent is worth 2 gold.
Okay, he'll pop off.
Now is this 2 medium creatures?
How much is a lyre?
L-Y-R-E is...
How much does a tent weigh?
20 pounds.
Answer my question fast. Crazy.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear your question, Pyro.
No, I'm being a shit. I'm getting a tent as well. I am a lady. I get my own tent.
A lyre is 30 gold pieces.
Oh!
Popper!
Most musical instruments one of those. Are expensive. Most musical instruments are expensive.
What about a hurdy-gurdy?
That's not on there, but I'm going to say a hurdy-gurdy for... What is for like a small one that is essentially the size of a music box, but with like a side crank, I'd say that's probably about 25 gold. Anything that's like monkey size is going to be 50.
Okay.
Well,
you know what I mean by monkey size, right? Like, you know, yes. The monkey with the hurdy-gurdy.
Any yeah. instrument?
Is there, what is your price range that you're looking for instruments?
I'm only proficient with the lyre.
Oh, you're only proficient with the lyre. That's really tragic.
Well, in my opinion, as an ex-DM, yeah, I get to say that. Since she is technically proficient with one, I would say she would simply have one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you can't really become proficient with it
if you don't have one.
Own it.
Yeah, if you have proficiency with it, unless it is something specific like a toolkit that you would need to buy, if you have proficiency with something like an instrument or a gaming set, then I would say you would have that. That's not really going to be like a big thing affecting gameplay. Because most of the tool sets, if it's going to give you proficiency in it, it's also going to give you in your equipment.
Okay. How much is a mace?
A weapon, a mace?
Yes. No, a can of mace.
Air mace. He's going to see you looking at the maces and...
5 gold.
Would you be interested in a warhammer instead?
She pulls a mace out of her backpack. No, just wanted to see how much this would sell for.
Is it heavily used?
Not really.
Then 5 gold.
She would have relied on her metal. Oh. Full returns on that thing, yeah!
If you barely touched it in a town like this, especially where they know you, they're gonna be like, yeah, 5 gold.
He's getting the Sister Leliboria discount.
Yeah, you have a good rapport with these people. If it's a merchant that doesn't know you in a bigger city, then they might give you Plato's Closet prices.
She's gonna just go up to the rack where they're hanging and just hang it next to it.
Man. How much would you say a hammock would be worth?
A hammock? I'd say that's probably the equivalent of
a bedroll, maybe.
Which is 1 gold. So I'll say 1 gold.
I will buy a hammock.
There you go.
Really, a hammock. Good luck hanging that out on the road, buddy.
You're traveling into a forest first.
Ever tried to hang a hammock while you're camping? It sucks. It's almost impossible.
Hmm. Good to know. All I know about is the hammocking people did in college, so.
Well. Not a big talker, are you?
No. I tend to keep to myself.
We can count on you in combat, though, right?
That you can.
Alright, that's all that matters to me. See, is there anything else I need to buy? Ooh. Go ahead and give me that hooded lantern and a little bit of oil for it.
Alright. Lantern hooded is 5 gold. 1 flask of oil is a silver. Mark off as many silvers as you want flasks. Lantern oil is easy to get.
Just one. He's only going to fill it once. Because he assumes that the cleric... knows the light spell. And that's just for emergencies. Actually, he's going to think double of it. Look at Sister Liliboria. Cleric, right? You know the light cantrip, right?
She casts light on a stick of incense and puts it in her hair.
Cool. Put a lantern's just for emergencies. Alright. I got a little bit of gold left, ready to stock up and get out of here. Is there anything else anyone can think of we need?
No.
Sister?
Nothing that I would need, no.
Silent but deadly?
I'm fine for now.
Munchkin.
How much... did the two-person tent weigh again?
20 pounds.
20 pounds. Can you carry
it? Oh, yeah! Let's find out!
That was your question. Two medium-sized creatures. Yes, I could say you could fit one medium and two smalls in there.
What I'm saying is I now have my own personal mini-palace.
Yes, you do. You can go spread eagle in that tent and just full starfish and not touch anything.
I haven't. All right, it hasn't told me I'm over encumbered yet. So there's just a massive thing on my back. I have lovely time.
He's booting up.
Hey, Munchkin.
Good.
Want me to carry that for you? That thing's got to weigh about half your body weight.
Checks bio. Almost.
About 9 pounds off.
All right.
It's great for a lich.
Pick up the other. Holy shit. There's a lot of scaly people in this group.
Yeah!
Odd. Oh, he's a lizard man.
We got a big dragon!
Hey, Tess?
And a gator. Yeah?
If Big Boy ever gets hungry, stay away from him.
Oh.
Just promise me that.
She sounds so sad.
Oh.
You're like one bite for him.
I don't think he'd eat me. He's all soft.
All right.
Sister walks behind Harka and nudges him on the shoulder a little bit. I don't think he's so uncivilized as to eat Tess.
10 minutes later.
And he's a lizard man.
Hang on. 10 minutes, just smash cut. So birds just do this? And I'm like standing in his maw, picking out trash out of his teeth.
Yep.
I just walk right in.
Alright, let's go pick up Big Boy.
Are you planning to pass through town on your way out?
Do we need to?
No.
I mean, I thought we were in town to do the buying. Oh, on the way out.
I mean, we are in town.
Yes.
Well, there's some people I would like to say goodbye to if we're going to leave.
Alright. Lead the way. You're in charge at this point. How long does Shield of Faith work in this game? Only Shield 10 minutes. Okay. I was wondering if it's like Mulder. Because I would have just dropped that shit on someone right now.
No. Also, I'd be looking for a way to get Long Strider right now.
Good coffee.
Alright. Sister will lead them. I'm sure she's been to Rex's temple before.
I thought you wanted to say bye to some people first.
Well, on the way out, right? Because we don't know if Rex needs something in town.
That's very true. Connor is booting up. So he should hopefully be here any minute. So if there are any conversations you all would like to have... Oh, he should be here any minute. His circle is now green and no longer on the phone. So I will go ahead and move you all to the Wild Temple map. Oh, it's not a map, it's art.
Oh. Tess is going to walk up to Icarus. And just, like, pull his sleeve.
There he is.
Yes, Tess?
You're my friend. I know you said you might have been afraid when I fiercely destroyed those other birds, but you're my friend.
And she'll hug your lip.
I will kind of pat Tess on the head.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, there we go.
Sister will turn to Harka. I wonder what her clan was like for her to be like this.
I have the sneaking suspicion her clan was relatively normal, and they kicked her out. I mean, bonus for us, she's a little ray of sunshine. Makes my skin crawl a little bit, but it's kind of nice. Reminds me of someone.
But I've heard this.
Sister just sighs.
Seems like a cool thing to do. Keep this quiet, the two of you?
I want to hear all of my friends.
I would have been trying to keep it a little quiet.
Harka's a dad, so no.
Well, then you definitely would have heard Harka.
Dare I say roll a perception check?
Roll a perception check. Sister.
10.
Oh, boy. Am I rolling like a...
Yes, stealth, but you're not at...
Stealth? Slide a hand, stealth.
Stealth, but not at disadvantage, because you're if you have that with your armor, it's just...
I do. It didn't matter.
Five.
Well, she's turns on the ball of her heel.
They were alright, but early on, I kind of walked to a forest, and these weird guys were just speaking gibberish at me, and then this other little lizard chased me, and then this big dog with a face on it. It was weird.
Most dogs have faces. That's
exactly what
no,
I was thinking.
like a guy.
Like a human?
Like a human face?
Eh, too ugly for that. Like, I'm more like a bugbear. Maybe human? It looks all scrunchy. Like if a human was a bulldog. Creepy.
Thanks for the nightmares.
It was kind of funny, too.
Alright.
I stole these guys' hats. They were red.
Systems walk up the steps.
Wait, what? You stole... red hats? Little goblin dudes?
Kind of.
Big spiky-ass boots?
Yeah!
What the fuck? How'd you live through that?
Hold on. Can Sister make a check on what that is?
I'm very heapy.
Make me... Gosh, what kind of check?
I mean, they're goblinoids, so it'd be nature?
Make me a nature check. Yeah, that's enough. You have read about creatures that are small, goblinoid-looking creatures with big spiky boots and red caps, called red caps. And they're not nice.
She's going to kneel down next to Tess. If you ever see those things again, please tell us or run, okay?
Definitely.
Okay. I mean, they kind of stopped chasing me after I ran into that funny lady's garden. I don't know. It's kind of fuzzy.
Scratch his head.
Well, as long as you're all right now.
Not sure if you have the worst luck in the world or the best luck in the world.
Just looks at me with these big old multicolored eyes.
We're walking right up to your temple right now.
Yep.
We came looking for you.
Have been vamping this entire time?
I came looking for
you. We have been discussing things and doing a bunch of shenanigans, yes.
They gave me coffee. They caught me after jumping off the roof trying to be a cat. I got some more arrows. We got some more tents.
Rolled our first official zero of this campaign.
Yep.
Yeah.
Tess to jump off the roof and got a zero.
Hey, everybody, welcome to Jackass!
Yep.
They're scrolling up to your temple right now.
Yep.
DM, give me the key when you want me to describe what they see.
Yes.
Well,
go ahead. Tell us.
You kind
of
see it.
No. Tell us.
Tell them about the inside.
I was going to start on the outside and work their way towards where Rex is.
Do as you will.
As you first crest into the standing water swamp where the temple's located. Sister Liliboria, you've come out here a few times. It's not a pleasant trek. There's a lot of gunk that you inevitably get covered with when you take this kind of trip. The first thing you will notice is this large, very moss-covered it almost looks like a ziggurat, except it's too vertical. And it has a sort of a mausoleum-like look to it. You know that there are stepping stones in the water to let you hop over to the steps Rex uses. And otherwise, there's a fairly deepish pond where Rex keeps a culture of fish. There are a series of wildflowers that are exquisitely cultivated and pruned that line the sort of edges of this area. And it has a very heavy, viney, almost like a curtain. Vines drop down, and this moss has been cultured so that it grows and weaves into a almost solid block. And the air in here feels different. Outside of it, you're swarmed with mosquitoes, but as you step in, it's almost like stepping into a botanical garden, but more authentic. As you make your way down to the steps, you will see that Rex is at the top, currently hunched over. Yes, he absolutely does that sometimes. Rex is hunched over with just a pouch of seeds and things, using druidcraft to move some things around. I'm assuming you all call out to him.
She'll just tap her finger on the side of the wall, which is probably loud.
As you're making your way up the steps, there is these colored, vibrant flowers that really shouldn't grow in a swamp environment, but Rex has worked very hard to keep them. They really are more like town flowers, and he likely got them from traders that came in, passing through town, paying for a clipping here, and catching a fallen seed there. As you make your way up, those of you proficient in religion or nature would probably notice some iconography on the walls, some pieced together mosaics that have been partially restored. Sister absolutely knows about this because it's a project she's helped with. There's different kinds of script over each of them, and they're all doing different things. And you will absolutely see that Rex is currently keeps druidcrafting and blooming a flower, then unblooming it, and just keeps trying to get it to set how he wants.
Wow, this is quite the place.
Oh. Yes, very. It's a bit of a project of mine is trying to fix this place up. I don't know if you heard me the other night, as I was mentioning the other temple, but this is the temple to the wilds that I live in. You will see there is a little hammock strung up that he sleeps in.
It's a nice place to visit.
You can probably see all of his belongings can fit inside the smallest crate you would ship on a boat.
Well, we have a job to do.
Yes, of course. I was just setting everything to maintain itself until I come back. You know, the flowers I've got set to hibernate as best I can, but they don't like to listen to me sometimes.
Yeah. The munchkin wants to say something to you.
Turns and gives his full attention to Tess.
First people who haven't been mean to be one. I was trying to come down here from the old clan, so I made you something. I gave everyone else theirs. Yours is a little different because you got the big head and all. Mm-hmm. And your arms look thick as well, so I made you a little hat.
What kind of hat is this?
All right, so this creation, if Liv will allow me a little creative stupidity.
I'll stop you if you go too far.
Is what appears to be a very strangely, at first looks to be a strangely, what's the word? Crafted basket, weaved, except it's too narrow, and at the top of it is a little pine cone. It at a game, it looks like a little woven together Pope hat with a pine cone for the tip.
I love that.
Are you trying to turn me into the turtle Pope?
I'm trying to turn you into the gator Pope. it comes with a chin strap, and then you're very wise. It could also double as, you know, if you've ever ridden a horse, that little like hard the hard thing in the saddle.
The saddle horn.
Yeah, the saddle horn. There we go.
Oh,
I called it a pommel.
It could double as that, because the chin strap is made out of pretty strong leather. That's the most expensive part of that.
Wow.
Seeing this gift, he will take it and put it on his head and goes, I suppose I should give you something in return.
You look back down, Tess isn't there anymore. She's already on your head.
He will grab you, take you, and set you in front of him.
There we go.
I will turn you towards the flowers cascading down the steps. Go pick a couple and bring them back here to me.
My greatest regret is this: then the mic did not pick up the squeak. Goddamn. Tess will squee at you and will skitter down the hallway.
That is really sad. The mic did not pick up the squee.
With the flowers you bring back to Rex, he's going to start using Druidcraft to elongate the stems. If you pull it too short, and make a little flower crown for you.
Yeah. All right, let's see. All right, Tess will bring you back a green flower, a blue flower, and a white flower.
Now, I'm curious what flower you think is green. Connor to Pyro.
Magic flower.
Algae.
Oh, you just grab a clump of moss?
She brought you moss.
Okay, we can use that for padding.
She brought you moss.
Green flowers do exist.
A blue rose, and... A white rose as well. I don't know. No, a white lily. There we go. Dab.
He will take the lily and its big, unwieldy, kind of tossed to the wayside. He'll grab a couple additions to it, like a couple magnolias. Grabs maybe a little, what's the bushy one? Chrysanthemums? Need to learn flowers.
Yes, I believe those are bushy. They are, yes.
Mm, it's not the one. Hydrangeas, that's what I was thinking of. So, but chrysanthemums too. And he goes and makes them into this very, very packed flower crown. And places it on your head. And then picks you up and sets you on top of his neck.
Yay.
Hey, Connor, I need you to make me a check for that.
Okay.
The flowers are
leather working.
Let's say leather worker's tools, yeah.
I think Rex is proficient in leather workers. I think I made a gag and I gave him. Oh no, I gave him herbalism kit. Would you consider herbalism?
I don't actually need you to make me a check. I really just wanted to psych you out with the leather workers' tools.
I really thought for a second I gave Rex leather workers to counteract the buffoonery, but I did not.
No. It's even better that you didn't.
Liv, you tell me what kind of creatures Rex could have convinced to live peacefully inside of his little sanctuary. Like, I said fish, but he would happily have any and all creatures that exist.
Well, first of all, the fish would not be inside.
Well, in the little water, obviously.
I like to imagine there's a full-on catfish the size of Tess just rippling around.
Absolutely.
So, call me Key.
Okay. I mean, just about any sort of swamp creature, in theory...
A large toad hops up on a stool.
Oh, very much large toad, yes.
I wasn't even thinking of Tom Cantu, you shit. The only sin.
Call me kid. Call me demon. Water forgets the names of the drowned.
And Rex is going to cast Speak with Animals and talk to the little toad that hops up to look at him. That is a second level spell, right?
First.
Oh.
Should be first.
Yep. He will cast it.
What do you say to the toad?
What does the fox say?
Lieutenant Horned Frog.
Lieutenant Horned Frog.
Yes.
I'm putting him in my NPC sheet.
I'm going to be leaving you in charge for a little bit while I go and take care of some things at some other swamps. You think you can keep everybody playing nice?
Affirmative, Ghost Rider. I got you covered. I'm gonna keep this shit locked down.
I appreciate
Tess stares at the toad.
Y'all can't hear this.
No, Tessie's Parker a good
stares at them talking to each other, not knowing what they're saying.
You can't understand what he's saying.
Yeah, I say something, it croaks back, and then I respond to it.
No, Tess just sees a toad.
Well,
food.
This isn't the weirdest shit I've seen so far today.
Sister's gonna grab Tess by the back of the shirt.
She's already seeing tastes like chicken appear in neon.
What? I want to pet it! Honest!
I will. Rex will actually give it a single stroke over the back of his head to have it watch the little eye, the frog eyes do the little blink as it pulls in.
They very much do the little blink.
Let me pet the frog!
If that little thing over there tries to eat me, I will be leaving, and I will not be coming back. You can count your ass on that.
I pick up Lieutenant Hornfrog, and I say, no worries. Remember, I'm leaving you in charge. And I yell to the fish, in case y'all missed it, he's in charge. As you all see me holding up a random frog yelling at fish.
The only sin is to deny your perks.
And then I launch him forward into the water.
Woohoo! Splash.
Alright. Things should be settled.
Ruins.
Well.
Tess just hangs limply from a laborious grasp.
I just wanted to pet it.
I imagine for the next 10 minutes
I got a 24 insight. There ain't no way you wanted to pet that thing.
I just wanted to pet it.
Pet it with my mouth and my teeth and my stomach. And I imagine for the next 10 minutes I hear like a snow white level of animals flourish around me and say goodbye.
Oh yeah. The catfish swims by. Bye, Rex. Hope you find your dad.
I'm not looking for my dad, but I appreciate the sentiment, but...
I was really hoping you were just going to say, thanks, Mr. Catfish, but no.
I throw a little...
Augustus
some problems to
Dahlia
him.
Comes walking in. My boy!
I don't know you!
I don't know you! God damn it, Bobby, what the hell is wrong with you?
But every little critter that comes and says bye to him, he throws a little crumble of food to him.
It's like sprinkling fish food up the top, and all the fish just come up.
Yep, you all will notice there are some actual like swamp gators walk up. Throw some meat
swamp
to them.
Puppy!
He's kind of very friendly, like grandfatherly to him. To the gators, he just kind of does the sup, chin upturn. They do the same.
Yeah, I was about to say, y'all have never seen a gator do the sup nod before, and now you have seen several gators do a sup nod.
Would you believe me if I said I've seen that?
You're the only person I would believe.
You're from Florida, so yes.
If you told me you saw a gator tap dancing at midnight, I'd believe it.
Okay, I wouldn't believe that. I'd believe if it was at 11 o'clock.
Witching hour. Anyway, that concludes all the fluff I was going to take up for the session describing... as I just set the home to energy
saver
mode.
Well, then we will make our way back to town with the whole party in case Rex needs to do. Thank you. In case Rex needs to do any last minute shopping, and so Sister can say goodbye to the people to whom she wishes to say goodbye.
A little laborious grasp.
All I need to do is change my suitcase. I have everything I need. And I've got good berry prepared, so I don't need to buy rations as well as Outlander.
I did look at that. I did look at that. Don't worry, I opened your sheet on my other browser, so nobody saw it.
I don't care. I'll keep that, keep that. We'll keep that.
I almost pressed port on reflex, I'm sorry.
We need to let the mayor know that we found the problem and dealt with it, for one. Then I have some people I need to speak to. So, right. First trip to the mayor's
you
office.
You need me there, or can I just go to the bar?
If you would like to go to the bar, I won't stop you.
Hold on, I haven't been paid for this job yet. I'll go with you.
I'm waiting for that.
Opens an empty purse, a single fly comes out.
So you make your way to where you know you can find the mayor. He basically works. He has like a little office in City Hall, which during the day he'll do his work out of so that people can find him more easily without having to, like, come to his actual house. And you find Bryce, Mr. Cartwright, in his office.
Ah, I see you've all returned.
Yes. We were able to find the shadows that were lurking out. They were creatures we found out were called the Ashen. But we are able to destroy them.
Well, thank you for destroying them. I will make sure that the merchants are made aware. As for all of you, he kind of looks around for a second.
You can see there's, like, papers and various scrolls and ledgers strewn across his desk that he's kind of fiddling with. And then, where did I put... Aha! Pulls up a little lockbox, opens it, and takes out a small coin pouch and puts it on the table. That is 250 gold for the lot of you. So that should work out to be about 50 each.
Nice.
Tess just holds 50 gold in her hand, and her eyes are just sparkling.
Tess, my dear little munchkin, perhaps you hand your money to Sister Liliboria, and she can just hold it for you. That way it's not jingling around while you're trying to hunt your little critters.
Her eyes dilate, and she holds her. This is my horn!
Mine! Oh, no!
She retreats onto Rex's back.
Baby's first horn!
We pick up my hat for a little dragon here.
Yeah, well, dragon!
Rex picks up the hat you gave him for you to store the coin bag under there.
That's awesome.
He places it, he puts it down. Now you can always know what's under there. And I give a wink to Harka and Liliboria.
Alright, so
this
are
is
you
one
holding
of the times
of my money?
Where you are very, very thankful for being a lizard folk because the uniquely flat top of your head.
Yeah. It's basically a bowl there already.
Surface.
Yeah.
So, just above character, are you holding on to Tessa's money? Or is it... Oh, you cut out a little bit for me.
You should probably put it in your inventory to keep track of it, but...
Yeah.
You can just say, like, it's stored on various pockets on Rex.
Alright.
He also plans on, like, asking you whenever you want to get it to buy something, like, so what do you need? Do you actually need it? And try and be a little bit of your impulse control. That was his goal.
That was Parker's goal as well.
Sister will turn back to the mayor. Speaking of merchants, Mr. Cartwright, have you seen Darius anywhere?
Yes, I believe that he should still be at his house right now.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you headed out?
Yes. After the encounter with the Ashen, things arrived and I need to travel somewhere.
Okay, then, now I really need to remember where I put this, and he starts rifling through his desk, opening drawers, opening files. Why can't I ever have any sort of cohesive system?
She'll raise her finger as he's mumbling to himself. I'll be back eventually. I need to visit temples.
But I have to give you this before you leave.
Parker rifling, will assist him in looking around, even though he doesn't know what he's looking for.
Can I make a perception check for anything with the Liboria's name on it?
Go ahead and make me a perception check.
He's literally just scanning around the room in case he sees it. Oh, that's a GM.
Yeah, a 10 is not. It's... You're looking around and being like, wow, I thought that the temple that I lived in when I first came to live in it was really disorganized.
This place is a mess.
It is very much... It is barring on... Yeah, none of y'all see it. It is barring on the organization of an ADHD person. And I say and this that... is someone with an, as an ADHD person where I'm looking at my desk and it is an absolute fucking mess. But
I know where everything on my desk is.
Yes. It's my desk. I know where it is.
I know where it is. He just has so much, and so much of it is from different things, and this has been here for a little bit. He kind of reaches into a desk drawer and pulls up a sealed letter.
Wait, I have an idea. Rex, Tess is going to reach into her hat and take out her her little bug. Like sack of money. I have an idea. I have an idea.
He will, sister. He will hand you the sealed letter.
Did I get mail?
Oh,
you got mail.
It's well,
Blue's Clues.
So it's not something that was delivered here. It's something that was left in my care by Godfrey.
You'll see her face gets. Like, all the confusion, it just goes into a solemn look. Oh.
Important shit.
I don't want to spoil the moment, but Shane, do you think Rex knows who that is?
It depends. Would Rex have asked about who lived in the temple?
Oh yeah, all about the Laborious life.
She would have told him that Godfrey is a man that she knew when she first lived in the temple.
Did you refer to him by that name, or did you refer to him by his title?
Probably his...
Because there are... That's you me gave me it. His actual name, but you have also said that you typically refer to him as a title.
Probably would have done the title, yeah.
You wouldn't connect that name with the title that you know.
She'd just look at the letter and snap back to reality and look up at the mayor. Oh, yes, thank you for giving this to me. And she'll just look back down at it.
You're welcome. I have truly no clue what's in there. I know that it's for you, and I know that it's something Godfrey asked for me to give you when you were ready to leave.
I guess he even predicted that much.
He was a very smart man.
Very wise.
Indeed.
Thank you, Mr. Cartwright.
You're welcome, sister.
She'll do a little bow to him and then turn around. Well, let's, I need to go stop by and speak to Darius.
Right. Lead the way.
And she'll scroll out of the office. Shall head to Darius's home.
Alright. Yes. The house is lively. You can see that they're all still home right now. A little bit of a smoke trailing up from the chimney.
Sister will look around. Does she see any of the other two strolling about?
Not right now.
Okay. As you guys are at the end of the yard with her, sister will turn around. I suppose you're welcome to join me up to the door. I'm not sure how Darius would feel about it, but...
I'll just hang out here.
I will occupy Tess by saying, hey, you want to try something?
Icarus?
I'll stand out here and wait.
She'll nod. And she'll stroll up to the door.
Alright.
Is it this one that Rex has decided to eat Tess and is just dangling?
Boom! You got all three stacks of an acquired taste.
She'll knock on the door.
Approach, and you're hearing the knock on the door. You hear gentle conversation in there. It's about breakfast time, so you gather. Footsteps come up. The door opens, and you see Kinry. Oh, hey.
Hello, Kinry.
What brings you here?
Well, things have happened. I don't want to talk your heads off about it, but Sarenrae, the goddess that I worship, has asked me to do something, and it'll take me out of the town.
You got a quest? No fair! I want a quest.
She smiles and laughs. And then kneels down next to Kinry. Well, don't worry, Kinry. There's definitely going to be plenty of quests for you to take.
Fine. Just save some of the good ones for me. I don't want you to get all the fun. Wait, if you're leaving, who's going to take care of the temple?
Well, I suppose no one for now.
I'll take care of it. Soph and I, we'll go take care of it for you.
She smiles. Perhaps. I would know that it would be in great hands if that were the case. And she pats Kinry on the head. How about I speak with your father? And maybe we can have that arranged.
Yes, Dad! Sister's here. I'm going to watch her temple. She runs inside, and Darius, what do you mean you're going to watch her temple? Kinry! So you can hear footsteps like running off to her room as you gather. She's probably going to pack already. You hear more small footsteps following her. Wait, where are we going? Darius, to anyone who's watching, this big, bulky-looking man, dark hair, kind of shaggy, a scar running through one of his eyebrows, walks up to the door. Oh, sister.
Hello, Darius.
What's this about Kinry watching your temple? What?
She's quite eager, but I had yet to hammer out any details to her. You know how she is.
That's very true.
Well, do you have the pictures? Do you want me to put them in the chat?
I sent them to you, right?
Yeah, I'll put them in.
Yeah. I think you have everybody should have access to posting the important NPCs. There we go. Yeah.
What a majestic set of facial hair.
Yep.
Well, Lady Sarenrae has asked something of me, and it'll require me to travel to temples across the continent. So, of course, when I mentioned that to Kinry, she immediately thought about the temple and volunteered herself.
Of course she did. It doesn't take too much work, right? Just a little bit of groundskeeping, more or less, at this point?
More or less. There's plenty of supplies left in there. I've set them for preservation, granted. Well, I don't know how often I get guests.
I think this will be good for her. She's a growing girl. It'll be good for her to have a little taste of responsibility that she's chosen to take on.
Also, I am sure you would like to hear as well that the shadow problem that the merchants have been having along the trade routes has been dealt with.
That
and she'll step back, turn, and let the group be visible from the door.
Oh. When they look back, what exactly is Rex doing to Desk?
Rex has, like I put in chat, when she agrees to try something, he will place his two pointed fingers on the top of her head and use wild shape to turn into a squirrel. Is then going to grab onto her ears and mimic her riding on him to just essentially ratatouille her around.
He's just running around on all fours.
Running her batteries low, essentially, trying to tire her out.
Impossible.
Exactly. But you're distracted.
All right, and then turn back.
That is... How old is that kobold?
How old did Tess say she was again?
11.
She said it earlier.
It's a bit fuzzy, but she's gone with 15.
15, as claimed by herself.
I don't think she specified years.
That's
15 anything, really.
Age for kobolds?
I'm not too sure.
Well, I suppose if they've gotten themselves this far.
She definitely knows her way around. She definitely knows her way around combat. But yes, I will do my best.
You can see his eyes widen a little bit at the idea of someone who is very much acting like a child in his eyes. Yeah, very much child soldier moment of being like, the fuck do you mean she knows her way around combat? How many combats has this child been in?
I have 100 confirmed kills, and
they call me the White Ghost. U.S. military asset.
No, they call me the White Death.
Doesn't flinch at torture or genocide.
The snow starts speaking Polish.
Well, finish. As long as you're willing to allow Kinry, I just wanted to stop by and let you know the whole situation.
Be safe, all of you. Kinry would be devastated. Kinry and Soph both, if anything happened to you.
She nods. Darius, can I ask a favor?
If it is in my power.
She'll pull out the letter from Godfrey. This was left for me. I'm not sure what's in it, but do you mind if I read it here?
Go right ahead.
She'll reach down and scrape off the seal and then pull it out and read it.
Would you like me to read it, or would you like me to send it to you so you can read it out loud, or not?
Send it to me and I can read it in her voice, because she'll probably say it out loud.
Feel free to take your time to read it as you go, and decide if there are things you choose not to read aloud.
To the blade, poet. If you are reading this, then I have succeeded. I hope that Godfrey has done as I have asked and guided you to this point. You have told him of your intention to leave Cressa and see the world. For what purpose? I can only hope it's to do good. Whatever the reason may be, it is of utmost importance that you take these words to heart. You are my own. Or your own. Oops. I may have created you, and Godfrey may have instructed you and guided you, but the choices you have made and the soul you have cultivated is yours alone. I've made many mistakes in my life, and people have suffered as a result. By making you, I begin my journey to redeem myself for the sins of my past. I urge you to take hold of the chance you have been given to live your life unburdened by the sins of your creator. She'll pause and look strained. Live well and learn all that you can. And then she'll fold the note. Farewell. And she'll just look off into the distance as she holds the note.
So that's from the person that made you.
Yes.
You never knew him, though.
No. When I awakened, it was only Godfrey.
I think now we know why.
Well, it's nice to have some answers.
Yes.
She'll just smile to Darius.
Answers are a great comfort.
She'll pocket the letter. Do you mind if I see them both one more time?
Come right in. He opens the door wider to let you in.
She'll walk inside.
You can Kinry. Make your way to the kids' room where Kinry is packing.
She'll lean through the doorway. Your father has agreed to allow you to watch the temple. There's plenty of supplies in there for you. Just please be careful not to... Anything that you don't think that you can handle that might be a little dangerous, please consider yourself and your safety, okay?
I promise, I'll be so careful. It's, you won't even know I've been there, except for things being just, like, super clean.
I couldn't imagine a better caretaker.
Thanks.
And she'll kneel down next to her. I imagine Soph is also there.
Yes, he is.
Hey, Soph. Make sure to take care of Kinry, too.
I will. Where are you going?
She will pull out the stick of incense with light on it. The lady who gives me this light to help guide me, she's asked me for a favor. And she wants me to help take care of other temples.
Whoa.
She'll hand him the stick of incense.
Do you promise you'll come back?
Of course. I wouldn't want to miss out on all the adventures that you and your sister will end up having. I want to hear all the stories, okay?
Okay. I'll make sure to remember them all so I can tell you.
Thank you. And she will pull them both in for a hug.
Soph holds on, but Kinry holds on a little tighter.
She'll run her fingers through Kinry's hair gently. You're a little fighter, Kinry. I believe you'll do much, much, and I can't wait to hear.
She kind of sniffs a little bit and rubs at her nose. Yeah. Well, you gotta make sure to come back so that Soph and I can fall asleep to all your boring stories again.
Did always like those.
They're pretty good stories.
She'll smile. Just, if you could help me for one last thing, Kinry.
Yeah.
Make sure not to do too good of a job in the temple, because then you'll replace me.
No one could ever replace you, sister.
I don't know. You're quite aspiring competition. And she'll pinch her cheek.
I'm not a kid.
No, I suppose not. And she'll stand back up. I shall see you both soon.
See you soon.
And she'll give them both a last little hair rustle. And she'll turn back to Darius.
I'm not particularly worried about you. I mean, I am, but I know you can fend for yourself. But make sure the lot of you watch out for each other.
He nods. Always. They're helping me, so I have to do everything I can to make sure that they are safe.
Good.
Then she'll hold out her arms for a hug for Darius.
He will pull you in. Very tight. Make sure you come back. None of us can lose anyone else.
She'll just close her eyes. I know.
When you pull back, he looks at the rest of you. Hey. Take care of her. If she comes back with even the slightest scratch, he holds up a wicked looking knife.
Squirrel pulls back on Tessa's ears to get it a halt.
I will see to it that you are all personally acquainted with this. Not a scratch.
The squirrel salutes.
I could always use a new knife.
Squirrel salutes.
Sister smacks Darius on the shoulder.
You don't know that's his leatherworking knife. It's like a leather worker's.
Oh, it puts a lot in the in. Ooh.
There's a little group of lizards. Apex.
Darius, come on. You don't have to do that.
Tess stares blankly at him.
That's not a knife!
No, pulls out his hand. This is a knife.
This isn't a knife either, but this is an arrow.
Yes, it is.
I'll kill everything!
The squirrel does a triple backflip off Tess's head and turns back into Rex.
Right.
I would like be my cry, very slowly best cry.
You know, no, she doesn't do that. Tess isn't an idiot. She has a very decent intelligence. She just looks at them.
I mean, yeah.
I walk up and I possessively hug Lily's feet leg, just
yeah,
just good glaring at him.
Mm-hmm. I promise I will do everything in my power, daughters, to keep her safe.
Good.
My heart.
I jingle the bag.
I took that back.
The flashing anime silhouette appears.
Oh. There's nothing. There's nothing under your hat right now.
You are quite nimble.
It is my job to do that. Yes.
If permitted, I'll make sure to send letters back to you to make sure that you know that everything's all right.
We would appreciate that.
Give me like 2 levels.
Shut up. Not metagaming, goddammit.
You know, are you talking about Speedy Courier?
I'm talking about sending you.
Sending.
I can do Animal Messenger now. I just gotta send them by carrier pigeon. It's a duration of 24 hours. I think I have a bird can fly in a day.
You have to summon Lieutenant Toad.
No, not Lieutenant Toad. Staff Sergeant Toad. He's gotta send it up the line.
Oh, wow.
Dead Lord.
Silence, Corporal!
God, I'm having this image of a fucking toad army. We're getting closer to establishing the Gaul, gentlemen.
We absolutely are not. I have allowed Lieutenant Horned Frog into my setting, but the Gaul will never
exist.
He's
a survivor from the dimensional breach. He's hiding.
The resistance is growing, gentlemen. We have a meeting this Wednesday. The code phrase is all hail.
I can't help it.
I will burn this campaign to the ground.
That's normally Pyro's move. Sorry.
Holy fire, you cut!
Drive by.
Also, God, I sent a whisper on the thing. It's fine if the recording sees it.
Ow!
A sister will look past Darius and smile to Kenry.
Fucking Drew took her levels from Rogue. I'll be right back.
She kind of peeks out from her door and waves.
Sister will wave. Alright, I'm sure you are a little busy eating and things.
Only a little bit.
Well, best of luck with... looks at the leather working knife. Your projects? And she'll give him a last bow and head down the steps with Tess clinging to her leg.
Yep.
Heavy foot.
All right,
so are we good to go?
Yes. Ready.
Stand up. Stretch, gets his hammer back where it's supposed to be. All right. Let's get this shit show on the road.
All right. Let me go ahead and put you all on the continent map.
Zoom in slightly. We need a party token.
I can cover 50 miles with this.
Let's go ahead and, for the first time in this campaign, roll a weather macro. How are your first day of travel is going? Partly cloudy, low chance of precipitation, low obstruction from clouds, warm temperatures from the region. Nothing cosmic.
I'm aroused by seeing you use this table.
Carry you gave on. Me this table.
I know, that's why.
Do you need a party token? I have one.
If you would like to make one, and the
I think Shane might have been itching to send forth your vote.
Shane is proposing a party token.
I'm listening.
Okay. Why did it do that? Thank you, token stamp. There we go. That should do it. Yes. Good.
By the way, did we decide which town we were going to first? I assumed it was Azmarin, then to...
Yes, Azmarin first.
It makes the most sense to go there, maybe charter a boat, maybe just turn around, and then...
Party token. Yeah!
There are no plans to go to Isithasar anytime. I approve of it. If the party approves, I am okay with that.
If that one isn't acceptable, I can make another. Of course.
Not up to me.
Hmm.
I have an idea I'd like to offer as a counter.
counter while proposal. Y'all are hashing that out, for now, I will use the sighted torch. While y'all are hashing that out.
Why?
I am going to go down the line in reverse order. It's like when the teacher starts at the back of the attendance list to call on people to answer questions. Icarus, if you would roll me a d20 for your first day of travel.
Yes.
Oh, my travel shit still has stuff about Fractal.
God damn it.
Oh, yikes. So sad.
No, not the back shots.
Well, I mean, it says if Fractal rolled a 1, ambushed by 2 dragon blood oozes and 4 rust monsters, anyone else random encounter by terrain.
The get fucked pyro option.
It was, if the metal man rolls a 1, he gets ambushed by things that say, fuck you, metal man. If it's anybody else, then it's just a random encounter.
I think I suggested that to you, didn't I?
Yes. Because it was when you weren't playing, you bastard.
I was like, you know what would be really funny is if Fractal just gets surrounded by rust monsters?
Yes, and then from there I said yes and.
I find your amount of racism toward robots displeasing.
Unfortunate.
I can't do the same joke twice.
I kind of like
Balgriff. I kind of have the energy of showing up to a Jarl's house in the middle of the night.
Jarl Balgriff! Not Jarl Balgriff!
I kind of felt like Balgriff in the night.
Hang on. I have...
I had to move my vote.
I would like to enter a last minute, just...
Never
like,
mind the fact that I got to, do that meme.
Like... Imagine you're the lord of a local town, and suddenly you see like a bright light to your back. You turn over, and you see Lulagoria there, a living sun, and then 3 lizards staring at you. It's like, so we are here.
A lord.
Is that Kratos?
That's the same guard seeing us walk
in. Is that Kratos?
Yes, Kratos.
Google, show me Kratos' balls.
Oh no.
Don't greet
Ares.
Destroy my enemies.
Hey Nasir, would you roll me a d8, please?
I think we're
a d8. Okay.
Just a d8.
I think Balgriff on the Knight's gonna win.
6. Very beautiful.
6 wyverns.
Actually, I have to rub mine.
Feed.
1 minute. I'll use the same forest map from earlier. Why not? You're still in the same area, more or less.
Rut-row raggy.
Rut-row raggy in reed.
Oh no. I'm a fool.
I don't know why you should say rut-row raggy. You guys are level 3. What am I going to throw at you?
Most of my spells are not in combat right now.
Did you prepare them for travel, or did you not prepare them after the...
No, most of the ones for that were combat, because I knew we were going to combat.
Oh, no.
Most of these were really non-combat, because I knew we were at the temple.
Would you all like that... do you all like the position of where you are right now, or would you like to move yourselves?
Can we start a different corner?
You may.
Has a day passed since I fell off the church? Or we
nope.
Said the
no.
Same day.
Same day.
Just checking.
If you like one to, you may start.
Oh, God.
I'm starting a different zone than the other one. I really don't care where. Yeah. I just want it somewhere different.
To the
I
north.
Like walking down the path.
To the north is nice.
Rex is definitely toward it's the just behind Harpo.
So if you would like to position yourselves.
And I'm just behind Rex.
Just put something in the chat when you've positioned yourself the way you would like.
I think good.
Okay. Three.
I mean, technically, it is the voice chat. He put his message in.
Works for me, as long as I have some confirmation. All right, cool. You make me a perception check, everyone, please. I want to see how you notice this.
If you okay, let's see if the wisdom caster's bomber again.
Tess, my eyes see everything.
I can't wait for us to get in that one.
Smell. Stinky. Rex, 26. Yeah, it makes sense. Rex and Tess, you smell, and you are very familiar with this smell, being hunters and wild people. You smell goat.
Goat?
You smell goat.
Goat?
As coming along the path. Hello?
Basic bitch.
Six.
The wild-shaped Pokedex goats. Comes out as I scan the giant goat.
Yep, you may add giant goat to your wild-shaped Pokedex.
Tess starts drooling, so little droplets just like pat around. Oh my god!
Six.
Liv,
what
Liv,
the
no.
absolute fuck?
Liv, no! They're stronger than you think!
I still have Speak with Animals prepared, y'all.
Grassland Encounters, levels 1 through 5, 1d8 giant goats.
What's the R of these?
Your tables are booked!
Yeah, go.
If I can know, or do
giant
you want to
goat?
Tell me after?
Yeah.
I can't imagine more than 3. A half? I'll bet.
A half? There's 5 of y'all! I think you'll be fine.
There's 6 of them.
I will, as they come into the path, I will cast Speak with Animals.
Go ahead.
You wandered in the wrong neighborhood, bitch!
Give me everything in your wallet!
Give me all your... Give me all your pants!
Meat bear, meat bear!
If you cast Speak with Animals,
yeah.
I'll say this one kind of gets the vibe. He, I feel like there's probably like some sort of connection of like, hey, this guy, there's something that changes and they're like, this guy can understand us. So this one kind of saunters up. What?
I was just passing by and wanted to just see if we could slip past you all.
Make these goat gangsters.
They certainly are now.
You're wrong.
They were a random encounter before, and now they're the goat mafia.
The goatsters.
Well.
Look at all this money we have.
That's a nice looking Avengers back you got there.
I don't even need to voice the goats. You guys are doing it for me.
Alligator skin wallet.
dialogue from the goat gangsters, from the goatsters.
I do love that you haven't really said anything for them, and we just decided they were going to be fucking the
I
goat
know,
gangsters.
I love it. All of these are actual things that they have said to you now, so Rex, with all of that knowledge.
I think we've gotten off on the wrong foot, folks. I really don't think there's any need for violence or hustling. We really just want to be on our way. Surely,
150 gold per person.
You would know what to do with gold.
It smells like fish
I know
in
exactly
here.
What to do with gold.
You
gotta
don't
pay
eat
the
it.
Toll.
Gotta pay gold, the troll toll.
Gold will go right through you. You can't eat
yes,
it.
Yes, it will. Rough.
Rex, what the fuck is going on?
you hear a series of strange bleats.
The goats are trying to mug us. I'm trying to convince them it's not worth
it's
it.
Get a knife!
Listen, there's only so many ways we can get out of this without any bloodshed on anybody's part. You are goats. You can very clearly identify a crocodile, an alligator. I really don't want to death roll you in front of your friends, but I'm not opposed to it. And he will stare them dead in the eyes, unblinking.
I appreciate that, but have you ever stared into the eyes of a goat?
You're staring into the eyes of an alligator?
I'm also now realizing that charisma is my dump stat on this character as I made an intimidation
check. I just want to point out, every time I've seen Connor play the face character,
it always goes well.
It's, it's gone very well, and now he's not even, he doesn't even have the stat roll on.
Go ahead and...
This is going to be great.
Go ahead and make an intimidation check.
See,
I was making sure Speak to Daniel doesn't give me advantage or anything. Nope, it just lets you talk.
It lets you have an intimidation check at all.
You see, Nasir, on Fridays we have the muscle to bubble through our shit. Okay. This one, in our other games, things fall through a little quicker.
he kind of backs up a little bit, goes and talks to his boys.
All right, fam, let me talk to my homies.
But there's got to be the one right behind him. There's got to be called old bitch. Is that? Oh, man, you backing down, you little bitch. This is why we don't
No, 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 I'm not backing down immediately. I'm just seeing what we all think.
Sister's going to lean in direct. Are we really being robbed by goats?
Yes, they want to eat our gold. And I'm trying to explain to them that it'll go right through them. And the so
doesn't
that
matter if it goes right through us. We're the Billy Goats Gruff, motherfucker.
So... we can eat goat for dinner.
We can. I've tried explaining to them. We really don't feel like murdering
them.
Why am
I not attacking these?
I mean, it's just kind of dumb.
The economy is a cruel bitch.
I just need to know. Fuck it. Harka's going to take a step forward and swing on this fucking goat.
Go right ahead. Goat right ahead, my friend.
Oh, no.
I will let you get your attack off,
negotiations
and then
broken
we will go
down.
Into initiative. 25 will absolutely hit.
I want to say I like to make a case for this being surprises. This seemed to have almost been proper out.
This dude
and then
probably does have his back to
us. I feel like it would have been, this one turned his back, and Harka's walking up, and all the other ones are like, man,
Let's see. Harka, I will ask you this. And because of your background, you absolutely can do it either way. There's not a right or a wrong answer. It's up to your choice of flavor. Do you come up very calmly and then out of nowhere just wah-ba-bam hammer him? Or do you come up with the hammer ready to swing? Because
he's fucking confused.
Yeah,
he's had his hammer out since he saw the fucking
goats. Absolutely wipes him out on the first one. And with that, we're going to go ahead and roll initiative.
He's just like, why the fuck are we talking to these?
That's a natural one.
Top of the food chain, motherfucker.
They're just like, he just had a baby. Like,
whoa. He was curious from retirement.
I had to use the Billy Goat's Gruff, man. I had to use the Billy Goat's Gruff. When I realized it was the Goat Mafia, I was like, this is the inverse of the Billy Goat's Gruff trope. Okay, one, two.
Tonight, I dine on goat!
That's everybody. Yeah! Sort. Icarus, my guy. Wait, hold on. No. Battle music.
You want me to get some goofy music, or?
Let's go with a little scuffle.
Play March of the Gladiators, man.
But this one's called A Little Scuffle.
And it has birds all over it.
It's funny.
So, now Icarus is required to get in there and crit something.
Come on, buddy. Icarus.
I will.
Show these goats who's boss.
I will saunter up to this goat right here.
Do it.
And then I will just make a attack.
That absolutely hits 10 damage.
Make
nice.
Sure to hold on, sneak attack. He's a swashbuckler.
He doesn't need a friend.
He doesn't need a friend near it.
That's so
just
cool.
As long as there's no other enemies near him, which
there's
not.
Which there aren't, yeah. Because that guy is very dead. 5. It's looking pretty rough. They may be giant and they may be goats, but they're half a CR, guys.
Yeah.
They do not have a lot of health and they do not have a lot of armor. All right, so it's your turn, Icarus.
And then I will take a step back.
Do you have
mobile?
I believe at third level you have cunning action.
I have that.
Yeah, it's part of the swashbuckler.
I was about to say, I was like, one way or another, I'm pretty sure you have the ability to take disengage as a bonus action, so you would at the very
He just gets that shit for free.
That's even better. Yeah, if you
He doesn't have the speed boost in mobile, but he does have the other
That
half.
Specific creature, yep, so you are all set. Rex
is going to look at him and go, I tried explaining to your front man that this wasn't worth it. Now you get to suffer the punishment of his terrible judgment.
Your
I'm gonna cast
man.
Wither. I'm gonna cast Wither and Bloom right here, so that it targets all the four goats. Actually, every goat.
Deny a weapon its purpose.
They are all gonna need to make me a Constitution saving throw.
All right. One, two, three.
I wonder
four,
if these goats
five.
Have good constitution.
Actually, no. I'm gonna go clockwise, so this will be
it's
four, and this one will be five. Okay. One, two, three, four, five. Okay.
The only one.
This one well, succeeds, and this one succeeds.
The DC was 14.
I think this one's already dead, though.
The DC was what?
14.
Well, yeah.
So,
the
20 succeeded. Everybody else failed.
Yeah, that one.
There's a
four
there's a 21
is,
in there, bud.
Four,
yeah, that's what I said.
So the natural 20 is just yeah. enough. Four damage is just enough to kill it.
Amazing. So, so you all will watch as
eight.
Rex is gonna.
Sorry, you narrate. I will. Mm-hmm. Quietly tell myself how much damage they're each taking.
Rex is gonna grab a bit of dirt, take a worm out of the ground, crush it in his hand, and you all are gonna see this black necrotic energy seeping out between his fingers. As he holds it out, there's just this blast that impacts the ground, and then the grass and plants around it thrive and flourish as if they suddenly siphon the life essence out of these goats that suddenly wither and rot. The one that dies looks like it's been dead for days. And just
nice.
Its eyes sink in and just falls over. And if anybody was in that aura, they could have regained some health. But
they weren't.
None of us even hurt.
Yeah, I think Tess is. Right?
Yes, because of their own actions.
I have gained one health. I can fight!
Alright, is that your turn, Rex?
Then, bonus action, I'm going to wild shape into a direwolf and move with the 50 feet I get.
Oh, we're
thank you.
Somewhere!
As you're zooming past, the liberal will be like, make sure to get the ones in the back.
Yep. And that's where I'm here.
Tess, you're powered up. Don't get in
after
there.
After getting whiplash from being dropped from a suddenly direwolf-sized creature. I'm going to lean off the side. Hang on. Yeah. pretend I'm on top of him instead of under him.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to.
And I'm going to.
Right click
yeah,
the back on my
temple.
There we go.
I'm trying to angle it to where I can breath up in as many as I can, but not him. Let's say I'm here mechanically. Let's see. Let me check the exact provocation on this cone right mirror.
Right.
You'll and definitely see, hit Rex with that.
Yeah, I'm trying to angle. Let's see, 15-foot cone. Let's see here. Boop. Now to use the handy-dandy roll 20 thing.
Yeah, you'll definitely hit Rex if you're standing on that corner.
Yeah, if you're standing on the back corner, you will be hitting Rex.
What?
If you're standing on that back corner, you will be hitting Rex.
Okay, well, I kind of want to, like, just, like, stand on the tip of his snoot.
Yeah, on that corner, you'll be fine. Because you can angle down and not have him be in front of you. Yes, that will work. And not hit Rex.
Hang on, me. I can hit
two. Yeah, I'm hitting two of them.
Yeah.
Pick which two.
I'll hit these two.
Those two? All right,
yeah.
What save is it?
It will be
one,
a con save.
Two.
And what flavor of breath weapon is this?
So, well, what you all see is Tess stand on the tip of the direwolf's snoot. Her head, like, her mouth unhinges like a Pez dispenser. And a torrent of cold air comes flying out, draping these things in frost. DC 12.
12? So the one on the left saves, the one on the right fails.
Yes. Let's see.
Breathe, weapon!
Breathe!
It's a D10 cone.
Yep.
Very
nice.
Nice. Okay, so the one on the left takes 5. One on the right takes all 10. Can you make that cone go away, please?
It's
not there for anyone else.
Oh, it is there.
Refresh.
Thing.
Refresh.
Doesn't Pyro just have to draw another shape and then it goes away?
Maybe.
I don't know.
Hang on. Let me try. Woo! Woo! Woo!
Yep, thank you.
There I go.
And then I'll scare to the back of the wolf.
That would technically get you an attack of opportunity from both of these goats. Would you still like to do that?
Yeah. Edge is mine.
Yeah. All right. This one looks on the verge of death. This one looks pretty rough, but not quite on the verge. Harka.
I'll hiss at it.
Valid.
Harka is going to march right down here. Occupy both of them.
Nice.
And then he's just going to take a deep inhale.
Yeah.
Lightning's going to course up his body.
Dex.
Oh, never mind.
And he's shooting straight south. So those two.
These two?
Yep.
Okay. One.
Oh, and I roll two. Shit for damage.
It's a con save for lightning? Not Dex?
Yeah, apparently.
All the breaths are con. It's just how it is.
It's the new one.
Yeah, at least these ones are actually fucking useful.
Okay, that's
yeah,
fair.
See, the,
okay,
the so damage scales top, better and we get multiple.
Success, so. This is bottom. Failure! Okay, so the top one takes one.
One.
The bottom one takes the three.
Harka just coughs a little bit.
little rusty.
That coffee breath is spicy.
It is spicy. It's
and then he's
acid.
Gonna
reflux.
Turn and point at Tess. And just say, don't get hit, little buddy.
Oh.
Okay.
And
I'll
shield of faith her.
Cute.
It's just
adorable.
A sweater. It's a dad sweater.
It's a Here. Dad sweater. Sister.
Can you dispose of the goat corpse, please?
Yeah, I'll scoot him.
Right?
Very
get
nice.
All three of them.
Yes, you sure can.
More coats. Yeah, roll 20.
Yeah.
This is probably, burning
okay,
hands.
One, two, three. That is the order of the deck saves. One, two, three. So all fails.
All of them take it.
The sister just walks up and holds out her palm where the core just lights up.
I don't know why
up.
I saved for this one. It had one HP.
Spits out flame.
Oh, pre-cooked.
Well,
this one is
it's a shame that we had to come to violence. But I'm not going to let my friends get hurt over this.
Roasted goat.
I T-pose on the on the goat nearest to me.
It's sister's turn.
Me or the direwolf, right. Bring it on. Alpha will take you on.
The giant goat on Harka is going to make a ram attack at Harka.
Ram
20.
That hits.
8 bludgeoning damage.
Oof.
And the one on the south is going to make a ram attack at the direwolf. 21.
That will hit.
For 9 bludgeoning damage.
Shield of Faith stays up.
Yep. That is the goat's turns.
I'm not going to bother writing down the damage I've taken because we've got a whole row of initiative.
Yeah. The
goats... Yeah, this fight's over.
The goats are, like I said, y'all were worried, and I'm like, they're half a CR. I can see their 19
Look,
hit points.
In my defense,
jump on them.
And they're 11 AC.
Had it been a little different with their initiative, they would have spread out and got all around us, and we would have not been able to AoE the hell out of them like we just
yeah,
did.
Yeah, in my defense, I've seen much easier looking fights go worse. I normal back me
baby.
Up. Well, we played Fendelvar. Those goblins are evil.
These are not goblins.
I also tormented the Northern Empire with goblins one time.
Alright,
yeah.
Icarus. 2 left.
I will come over to this one.
Nice. Remember your sneaky attack.
He's the goat!
And then just attack once.
Oh.
11. That will
Snake
take
eyes.
It out. It had 4 HP left. How do you kill this goat, Icarus?
I will kind of throw my scimitar into the air and then pull it down on its head.
Nice. Dead goat.
And watch this.
Fancy, 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 fancy.
Tess is clapping, very entertained.
It's almost what you would call fancy footwork.
What?
And that'll be my turn. Yes.
That is a beautiful turn. Rex. Only one goat remains.
The dire wolf will walk up. And I think Speak with Animals will still carry through to the dire wolf.
Yeah.
Just, you know, I carry the effects. He's going to say, I hope in the next life you make better decisions. And I will make a bite attack at advantage because it's tactics.
I like the idea of a dire wolf just...
Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Goat reincarnation.
Yeah,
16 will hit for 10 damage. They have an AC of 11, guy.
That was advantage, Liv.
Oh, yeah, 16 will hit.
Because pack tactics. The damage is 8. And strength save if it survives or be knocked prone.
Okay. It survives. It has advantage on strength saves against effects that would knock it prone because of sure-footed.
Okay. So 13, it has to make.
14.
It succeeds and is not prone. And I will move to...
It does that thing, you know, the myconic goats, the freezing goats, you know, the ones mm-hmm. that are experienced, yes. They've done this before, and they just kind of lock. It's like that.
Yep. Okay. I will go to the flanking position and end my turn.
Eudemus. Tess. It's looking pretty rough, Tess.
Approaching! Yeah!
That will definitely hit. 17 what?
17
piercing damage.
It doesn't matter what kind of damage because it had 3 HP, but just because it came up as no damage.
It explodes.
I was curious.
I pull out an arrow, there's just a brick attached to the end of it.
Didn't that have a negative 5 attached to it somewhere?
It's...
For sharpshooter?
Yeah.
I mean, what's it's still point? A 12, but so it hit, but...
Oh, no, yeah, I did that. Yeah, there's only a plus 1 to the attack. That's what the issue.
If it's at least an 11,
oh, no,
it will hit.
Only one. Yeah. Yeah, that's already factored in.
Then, yes, you're fine.
Yeah. I just begged it into the sheet, see where it's all says it's...
Oh, yeah, there it is. I just didn't see it.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Go over to... The regular background music again. There we go. You have killed all of the giant goats. Remove all turns. Clear list. Clear. Exit. Exit.
Don't worry, I gave it an anime.
Yes, you did.
Wow.
I will hop out of what direwolf form and start pulling out some hunting knives and go, well, time to start carving.
I am already looking up the harvesting for a giant goat.
It's literally just the horns and meat, Liv.
That's it?
I can't, well, I'm saying I can't imagine there's much else.
Give me a spleen!
So Cinderwell's standing over the two torched corpses she made.
Goat, giant. There we go, thank you. Goat, comma, giant. Goat, giant, yes. Goat, hide!
Okay.
Giant goat, horn.
Yeah, Tess will assist you, so go
see
and do
if there's
that.
Anything else in goat that is not included in there. Nope, hide and horns.
Okay.
Nature check.
Nature?
Yes.
Okay.
Because this creature is an
well.
Beast.
Alright, I'm proficient in that as well.
This is from thebeastguild.cc.
25, because Tess just said she was helping
me. 25 absolutely succeeds. Because it's a natural 20, I will give you both of them. There, you have 5 pounds per goat of giant goat hide.
Yep, 30 pounds of goat hide.
And 12 giant goat horns.
You know, I could have easily vaporized that whole encounter with my channel divinity, but I didn't want to.
It was just a random encounter. I didn't need to do that.
Had I rolled solid on the channel divinity, it would kill all of them.
Yep.
Was there max HP?
19.
Ah, well.
Yeah, I'm over my carry capacity.
I would've...
Who wants some of these hides?
I'm gonna be over my carrying capacity.
Hess politely declines. Shit, I think I'm approaching my limit just holding on to
their
my fucking
bedroll. Their coat is primarily used in apparel and bedding, and the giant goat horn can be used to make a large drinking horn or in the creation of an instrument called a buca horn.
Icarus will take two hides.
Nice.
5 pounds each.
Could I have sold my rations in bedroll as well? Because I realize that they're taking up quite a bit of weight, and I don't use either of them.
Yeah, you can absolutely have sold them.
I think rations is what?
Rations.
5 silver each?
Yeah, 5 silver a day. So 5 silver per. And then a bedroll is 1 gold.
So that would be...
1 gold per 2 rations. So if you have 10, you would get 5 gold.
And then bedroll is 1 gold, so...
11 gold.
Okay.
11 gold!
We're rich!
11 days!
We're rich!
Alright. Go ahead and remove the goats from the mat.
That was like 26 pounds of stuff that I can't use.
And back to the regular map.
That was weird.
We eat goat for the next few days.
Yeah.
I imagine we got the meat.
Oh, yeah, you got the meat.
Hunter-gatherer outlander.
Yeah. I just think it's not like a crafting thing, so it doesn't show up on there, because it's like, what are you going to do with it other than eat goat meat, regular goat meat? You're going
to
eat it.
I might argue that survival... quite literally hacking up beasts to use all of their parts. It might be better than nature.
Bestie, my love, you are the one that sent me the Thieves Guild link.
But Bestie, you are the GM to adjudicate the rules and change them as you see fit.
And maybe I didn't want to.
Okay.
You succeeded, didn't you?
I only took expertise in survival to fit into this niche.
Have you been admonishing me from day one from doing modifying shit?
No,
aren't
that's
the one
me.
Who,
it's your first day of travel. Is there anything you all would like to do as you... Actually, go ahead and make me a survival check to find a good place to set up camp. Go ahead, make me a survival check.
Thank you.
No one can help you. Him? You have expertise.
I'll see myself out. But
may I roll?
You may. You may roll your own survival check.
Hold on, we gotta get another. We gotta get another.
Almighty. And yet another 2. The wisdom casters are not on it tonight.
Y'all are all looking around. Y'all are all looking around and just looking.
Harka's just standing there. These idiots are gonna get us killed.
Harka, what kind of area do you find suitable for your night's rest?
Blocked from the main road. Behind some bushes.
Yep.
Nice and fucking flat.
Yep. And you're like, you just kind of move some bushes aside and go, guys, right
Yo.
Here.
But flat land. Good to sleep on.
But the plant.
Good for my
just
back.
Grass. It's just grass.
Yeah.
You're amazing, Marco. I didn't see a thing.
There's just two rocks in my eyes.
Divinity source apparatus folds up on her back as she plants the glowing stick of incense with the light cantrip on it in the middle so that we could set up camp.
Nice.
Marco will set up his tent, take off his armor, and none of you can join me. Crawl into his tent.
So Tess sets up her tent as well and then just proceeds to pull a U-Haul truck in.
Did you get tents for everyone?
No.
No.
Okay. Can I make a tent out of my goat hide?
That's a leatherworking check.
That is a leatherworker's
check. That's a leatherworking
check. I will say, I don't have the tools for that.
Does anyone have leatherworker's tools they'd be willing to let Rex borrow?
No. I will be stunned if you do.
Then you can make me a general dexterity check to kind of prop up the tent as like a, or the hide as like a makeshift tarp.
Okay.
But you won't be able to make it like a permanent, this is my tent forever.
Okay.
Sister's gonna play her lyre for the first.
You get it all set up, and it's nice, and you crawl under there, and the two tent poles collapse right on top of you.
So, seeing this, Tess walks out, seeing him just lying under a bed, lying under a pile of dirty, not even fixed
leather.
He
doesn't even bother getting up, he just lets himself be covered in it.
She just walks over. Just taps you on the snoot. Hang on. Taps you on the snoot.
Sister will do the first watch, and she will play her lyre as everyone is falling asleep. What stat do you want me to roll for that?
Tess just like pulls on Rex's hand, just back toward her tent. Come on.
Okay. Not bad.
She can't move you, but she's trying to just pull you.
Very nice, very comforting.
I drew a crab.
I shall do perception for the watch. Worse than my liar. Somehow.
What was that, Connor?
Just as you're poking at him, a druidcraft and a white cap grows on the end of your nose.
Just come on. It just tries to drag you back. Go on.
He gets up. Boom. And on all fours walks into the tent.
Shows you the palace. Just.
It's bigger on the inside.
Alright, and then in the corner where Tess is sleeping, there's a little pile of garbage and gold that I'm sleeping on top of.
Nice.
I will coil up next to it.
Good, he's closer to the door. Someone tries to kill me, the other guy. Go ask him.
You got a guard gator.
Yeah. Swamp puppy.
He, when he snores, does kind of do the gator churl.
And did I hear right? Icarus has a hammock.
Yep.
Yes. Bird up.
Bird up. Rolled a 14 for the watch.
If... All right. You don't notice anything.
Do lizard folk have dark vision?
Mm-hmm. I have light.
They do not.
Oh. So in the darkness, you should see my little glowing eyes.
Meow.
Doesn't even. He barely blinks at it.
Grant, still wake up for second watch.
Me? I said I would.
Okay.
I will stretch as his back hurts from laying in this tent. Go and do a stroll and see the Liboria. Lily, why don't I take over watch for a little bit? I need to be upright. My back's hurting.
As you wish. She will hand you a lit torch, since the light only lasts an hour.
Yeah, that was the Liboria have a tent.
Nope. Sister will just go towards, like, the nearest nice spot that overwatches everyone and just sit down, cross her legs.
Damn. I thought I was going to have a heat lamp.
Nope. And she'll just assist with watch in her shutdown state.
There are no strings to hold me down.
21.
Damn.
You notice the gentle passage of animals, but Harka seems to have found a fairly safe place for you all to rest for the night.
Nice. He will not really do anything else, just kind of play around with druidcraft, bloom random flowers that shouldn't be here. He'll reach into his side pouch, and he has a whole, like, mixture of random seeds he's found that he hasn't identified. They're not native.
Do not.
He throws them out, and then just druidcraft blooms them.
Okay, we'll make a little mark.
mark in my...
They're not anything like kudzu. They'll likely just die. Like, they're not... Flowers are not notorious for being very hardy plants. They are just flower seeds.
Roll me a d20.
Okay.
Okay, thank God. If it had been a natural one, some of it would have been mint.
Oh, no.
Infested the area, you monster.
There's no mint.
But he'll bloom some hydrangeas. Is the soil acidic or basic, DM? Or a mix of both?
As basic as you.
Ugh, 2 seconds before me, you shit.
Basic.
Blue hydrangea sprout out.
Alright, who's doing third watch?
I'll do it!
Imagine you get up to, you notice Rex is gone, and he's there doing an old man stretch with his back. And he will gesture you to the log he sat on. And he's going to lay just in front of your tent, on his back, belly to the sky, splayed out starfish.
This will sit at ready stance, with one arrow just sitting there, staring out to the darkness.
All right.
Perception.
Yep.
Hey-yah! 21.
Another 21. Again, you don't notice anything other than just the general passage of nocturnal and early morning animals.
I hum a little tune to myself.
I've got a lovely bunch of coconuts here. They are sitting in a bunch.
Who's doing fourth, Tessa, or excuse me, Harka or... Ickerts.
Whoever Ickerts tests decides to wake up.
Who do you go to test?
I fear what happens. I naturally respect going to another dragon's den, so I'm not doing that. I also fear because...
we lack coffee.
Yeah.
You got a druid. You can probably do some...
Then I immediately look into the... I immediately look into the canopy and see the hammock.
Oh, shit.
And I'll just, like, clamp onto the tree and go,
this is my real trim my nails.
I will attempt to go up and get Icarus.
Okay. Yes?
Your turn for watch.
Alright. And I will help Tess down from the tree.
Thank you so much. I didn't want to ask, but... Whee!
Then I will walk into my tent and just splay on top of Rex's belly.
Flop.
Just curled like a cat, making biscuits.
Alright, and then...
19. Yep, so very much the same. It's now the very early, late nocturnal, early morning animals. Harka really does seem to have found a good place for you all to rest for the night. Very safe.
And while Icarus is watching, he will kind of count his money and do some mental math. And then I will go. Yep, go sorry.
Nope, go ahead.
If we have another watch, I will go wake Harka.
Just the four, typically.
Okay. Yeah, it's each watch is 2 hours.
Okay.
So, eight hours of resting and all that.
Do we wake up?
Yes, you do.
Rex will wake up, groggy. Did I hear you say something about Kofi, Tiss?
It tastes terrible.
What is it?
It's bitter bean juice? Bean soup.
Sister will stand up as she reactivates. Coffee. She had coffee.
Is that that ground bean drink? The ground.
Yeah, it's bean soup.
No, it's not soup.
Oversimplifying it, but yeah.
Oh, were you a fan of it, Harka?
Yeah.
Hmm.
He has droopy eyes right now.
Oh. Does anybody have any water? I'd like to try something.
Tess gives you her water back.
Rex will pull out of his bag just a little bowl and some tiny cups. Actually, could some of the like light activity I'd done last night just been carving some of the goat horns into like drinking stuff?
Sure.
Because I think Rex honestly had one cup of his name. Maybe two. Probably two. And so he's carved some goat horns into cups, stabs them into the ground, gets his bowl, and he's going to pull out a druidcraft nearby bush to sprout a sprig of mistletoe, snap it off, and cast a good berry. Going to break them open, take out the pits, grind them, wrap them in a little sheet cloth, put them in, ask Liliboria to give him a light as he's holding up the bowl for water.
Like fire or light? Heat?
I need some heat.
Harka's going to start his morning calisthenics.
Tess will mimic him and also do stretches.
Will you allow me to provide heat as flavor, or will you want me to cast Burning Hands or something?
Literally just using you as the, like, stovetop to boil the pot. It
just lay down and just put the pot on her belly.
I mean, the Divine Apparatus probably could just hover there and hold it. But the end result is that Rex has these, like, deep-hitted good berries, which are like look like large cherries, but with very short stems. And from the ground bean, the ground pits, he looks at it, it's like brown water, and goes, "This smells like coffee. Harker, you want to try some good berry coffee? See how close I got?"
Good berry. Berry. That would be tea, my friend. You made tea.
Well, not technically. It's the ground pits of it. You see, the coffee beans also come from a sort of pit-like structure inside of a fruit.
Heard those are cyanide.
That's apple seeds.
Oh.
But, you know, I've ground it up, and I think I've got it close. And then, as a bonus, they've got a little bit of a good berry flesh to nibble on. Hmm. And he will pour some good berry coffee into a cup for you.
Sure. Why the hell not?
Liv, what kind of check do you want me to make to try to see how good of a barista Rex is?
Make me a survival check.
No. 23.
Pretty good. It's pretty good coffee. It's like really good campsite coffee.
Liv, you had a chance to make medicine relevant. You had a chance.
But it's not, though.
Damn. Rip.
Darren has a heart attack.
Looks at it. This shouldn't be possible. Drinks it. Definitely shouldn't be possible.
You feel the magical sustenance.
This is passable coffee. What and the
don't
fuck?
Forget, don't forget to have some of the fruit with it.
Yeah, I'll be eating that separately. I don't like my liquids to be chewy.
Oh, yes. I mean, it's not floating in it. It's a little. He's got a little dish. Like he's got.
Yeah, I know. I don't like to mix.
I don't like my medicine. Dry it out. Touch my peas.
No, eat one thing, then I move on to the next.
Mmm.
What is so hard about this concept? I
don't mix my food.
Connor is having a role play as if that isn't how he's eaten every meal the entirety of his life. I'd like to have also got a little bit of goat meat cooked up to go with breakfast. Yes. Actually, could I have made it jerky? It might take a long time to dry. I don't know how long jerky takes.
I was about to say, I don't think you could have done that overnight.
So this one for now, and he'd also need some salt. So some very locally sourced herb seasoned goat meat.
Sister's going to stroll up to Tess. You still have the hoard on the ground that you're sleeping on?
It is in the tent. But, okay. she hasn't gathered it up yet.
Okay, she'll stroll into the tent then.
Welcome to my palace!
Mind if I make a tribute?
Yeah! Duff!
And Sister will kneel down and put 10 gold into the hoard. And then she'll put her hands together. Just so that I gain favor with the great dragon.
Puffs her chest out, feeling pride.
The great dragon chest will allow this.
Just turns up her chin. Unbalances and falls back into her pile.
She smiles and stands up and heads out to, I imagine, since Harka and Rex are doing the coffee thing, to Icarus and holds out 10 gold to him.
Thank you, but you didn't have to.
Well, technically you're all here helping me. Makes sense to pay you for your jobs.
How about this? I take 5 now and 5 when the job is done.
He smiles. I suppose that's acceptable. And she'll bow and then head over to the coffee duo.
You'll have to give me more tips on how I can improve it. I usually don't have this sort of thing, so... I've mostly eaten jerky from what I've cooked, but it's nice to have an opportunity to try and get some variety.
I'm going to be honest with you there. I've kind of worked as a guard most of my life. As long as it doesn't make me sick, I'm fine with it.
I will endeavor to raise your expectations then.
All right.
And I noticed the Liboria walking up. Lily, did you need something?
Not particularly. Don't really need. She motions to the coffee and good berries. It doesn't go through me very well.
It's unfortunate. It's actually pretty good for some reason.
She'll sit down on her knees and hand 10 gold out to Harka.
What's this for?
For joining me to the temples?
You're hiring me.
Well, in a way, yes.
All right. He'll take the gold, add it to his pouch. Got yourself a mercenary.
Then she will hold out 10 gold to Rex.
Oh, I'm paying you back and gonna collect on this in the form of a help restoring more than mosaics. You can hold on to it. Last time I checked the counter, I owed you a favor at the temple. I'm cashing that out here. And then a few more.
Face just gets into a light scowl.
I keep very extensive records. I couldn't be wrong.
Fine. And she just crosses her arms.
He's just gonna smirk. Hey Tess, come here, I want you to try something. He's got a cup of Goodberry coffee ready.
We've been through this song and dance. You're evil. Tess comes out with a bag strapped to her side.
Now,
yeah.
How, we're in a forest, right? How far away is a beehive?
How far away is a beehive?
I want to harvest some honey, and I have speak with animals to just.
And a portal opens, and orc walks through, hands you a jar. Enjoy.
I'm gonna be having a forest. I don't know how hard it would be to find.
Where?
Essentially, Rex is gonna try and like put a healthy dollop of honey in Tessa's coffee to see if she likes it this way.
Okay.
I would like to put to it that the sister and Harka see this. Maybe they have opinions.
Okay.
I'm giving Tess more coffee.
That's honestly not the best idea in the world. Last time she had coffee, she jumped off the roof of the chapel.
10. Two. Yeah, no. Two's in the chat. Yeah, no, with a 10. You look around what you're looking for, I'll say with a 10, you're looking for like an apiary. Which you can't find in the middle of the forest.
He will hear the thing from Harker and go, "Alright then, you can have my share of fruit tests." And the two cups with coffee and the two little things of fruit. Both things of fruit on one plate, and Rex just double fists the coffee.
Please don't say that.
Mm-hmm. Double fist in the coffee. No. And then I will slide the little fruit slices over to her with some of the goat.
It's just like a little kindergartner. You're trying to open a fruit cup and tears. Just
hang on. I would like something. Liv, can I have pressed some of these into a fruit roll up, like a fruit jerky? For Tess.
Sure.
Are you trying to sneak me pills? Like,
no. The image of Tess having a fruit roll up, as you mentioned, kindergartner, seems very fitting. And
this
Rex
is the only way
more fun to eat.
This is the only way we can get him to take her out of rock.
Sure, you can have done that.
Cool. So you have a little.
That's a riddle insert.
You got a little.
That's
fruit jerky.
That's fruit stronger. Roll-up.
And
chomp.
Can I roll to see how well I cut the goat into dinosaur nugget shape?
You cut it just fine.
Dino nuggets and fruit roll up for breakfast.
Roll for a nuggies? What the fuck is up? This is such total whiplash from every other character I've played. I'm shook.
Yeah, you and me both, buddy.
I think Lou's taking a sigh of. Did my player just ask to roll to cut up dino nuggies in the game?
That's exactly what's happening.
Dino nuggies for pyro?
What's happening.
Listen, I have a usual type of character. Bitchy twink, who causes problems
that's
on
just
purpose.
You.
The closest creature I can come to this thing's mindset is Brawn, but Brawn is like an 8-foot tall titan of a man, and this is a little baby. Bruh.
I will call over Icarus.
Yes?
Did you want any of the coffee? I've made some. It's magical enough to sustain you for the day.
Sure, I'll take some.
Icarus, also, Tess walks up and offers you a nuggie.
Why, thank you, little one.
Yeah!
She eats the rest of it.
I just cut them into shapes for her. I feel like it'd keep her occupied as she tried to figure out what they were.
They're gone.
And I don't know if you in particular, If there's something you like, your breakfasts or meals a certain way, let me know. I'm having quite a bit of fun cooking for more than sustenance.
We'll definitely keep you in the loop.
I would appreciate that. Think about now, Rex's eyes start to dilate. Oh, that's a nice little buzz from the drink. I don't think he's heard of coffee. I don't think he's really ever had a need for it before.
All right, Bruce. Oh,
that's good.
Intervention!
Oh, that's good.
Suddenly, Tess looks like a dino nuggy. Oh,
the gator teeth start to, his lips pull back. Just. I would say Lil Ivory would probably notice, because she's got a good perception, that Rex leaves himself a considerably smaller portion than everybody else, and that he made a batch and then made his plate based off what was left over, and he guesstimated a little short.
Sister just looks at him, squinting her eyes. They're like double the body mass of the rest of them, really?
I mean, I don't want to keep us here just cooking another thing for me. I can nibble on things.
Sister will stand up, looking at him the whole time, go over to the huge pile of goat meat. Rip a piece off, start cooking it over the fire, staring at him the whole time.
Alright, well, if you're going to do it, at least do it right. I'll grab a little paint, the bowl that he was doing some seasoning in. Start to make it up right.
Good. We definitely have enough. There's no reason to go selling yourself short.
We gotta keep you big and strong so I don't have to walk.
Good point. If I skip a meal, I might shrink. Then how would you be able to ride on me?
Muscle shrinks
enough and disappear. He does.
With the armor, absolutely.
No, just naturally.
Without the armor. Harka is compressed muscle.
Harka's about 280 pounds.
And Rex is fat.
For now.
Wait, 280?
Yes.
Sister's heaviest here. Sister's the heaviest one here.
She's Rex all metal, like man.
289. Yeah.
Rex had like a 250-ish. So he's not that much more.
Well, I guess you can count the divine or the divinity source apparatus.
Jesus, that adds some weight. Also, Lily, I've got a spell that I haven't really used all that much. It's an alteration on the speaking to animals one. It lets me send a courier, an animal courier, carry things to places. Messages. And I overheard you mention wanting to send letters to a Darius fellow. I thought maybe this could be one way to send it along.
It's been a day.
Well, if I get the idea, I will request your assistance.
Sounds good. Just, give me a night to finish working out the kinks before you're ready to send the letter, and we'll send it off in the morning or the evening after you let me know.
She'll nod.
And as I upcast it, I get, a lot of additional time as we gain spell slots that I can send the creature further and further away. Every spell slot above second, I get 48 hours added onto it, and a bird can travel the 50 miles a day with the spell.
Damn. Nice.
Yeah, so it lets me send stuff back relatively quickly. But I have to send it to a place I have been to before.
Well, it'll get there pretty fast from the looks of it.
Yeah.
5 feet away.
5 feet.
I mean, we travel 24 miles in a day. So at this current level, today and tomorrow, we could get there.
Well, I assume we're getting our second day of travel now.
Tess.
Are we still going? It is.
Yeah.
Do yeah, I mean, Pyro's the only one.
The next day, or
thing is, I don't work tomorrow. I have tomorrow off. That's why I haven't said anything. I'm good.
Yeah. If everyone good to go, Nasir.
I unfortunately have to be up early in the morning.
All right, then this is a good spot to call it before we start our next day of travel.
I was only going to be good to 10:30 anyway.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Oh.
Thank you so much for coming. Yes. This was a great game. We have
glad I was here on time.
Started on our quest.
Yeah.
Loving the role play between this group.
Hell yeah.
When you guys have officially decided on a party token, just at me with the one it is in the chat, and I will make it the official party token.
I think it's Balgrim.
Yes.
Unless Nasir.
I only see two votes. If I can get all five of you to
majority vote, three
majority vote, because there's five of you, so I need at least three.
Unless Nasir, what wants to put? Yeah.
Yeah.
Jarl Balgruuf it is. Do we like him with the beige border?
I can change the border if you like.
Change the border.
Change the border. Okay, there we go.
Make it a grayer color, not as saturated.
All right, we will pick that up next week, and I think if y'all can all help me remember that we will begin next week with the reveal of the party token. And with us having a party token so soon, maybe we could start thinking of names for the party.
No.
We'll see. We'll think about it. I'll see y'all next time. Thanks for watching.